Okay, so here's a quick demo of the effect of sampling rate and of quantization in terms of bit depth. So what you're hearing now is recorded with a sampling rate of 48 kilohertz and 24 bits of quantization. I'm now going to leave the bit depth where it is and just change the sampling rate. What you'll hear is a subtle reduction as we switch to 44.1 kilohertz. Could you all hear that? No, you couldn't, because all it did was reduce the maximum sound we can encode from 24 kilohertz, which you can't hear, to 22,050 hertz, which you also can't hear. So there's not really a huge difference there. Let's drop it down. Now we're going to halve it to 22,050 hertz. In that case, we've just actually dropped that frequency content down to 11,025 hertz. So that's the maximum frequency that you can encode with that sampling rate. Dropping it down to 16 kilohertz sampling rate, the maximum frequency we can encode is 8 kilohertz. Dropping it to 8 kilohertz now, the maximum frequency content is at 4 kilohertz. Dropping it to 4 kilohertz, we have reduced our highest frequency down to 2 kilohertz. Obviously, with 2 kilohertz, we've dropped the highest frequency you can encode to 1 kilohertz.
And now with a 1 kilohertz sampling rate, obviously the highest frequency you can hear is 500 hertz. And some of you will have quite a lot of difficulty in understanding what I'm saying.
There you go. Now let's keep this nice high sampling rate that we've got, and we're going to alter the bit depth and see what effect that has. So here we are again with our 24-bit quantization, and that gives us 16.8 million voltage levels, or a 144 dB dynamic range. More than sufficient, I'm sure you'll agree. Dropping it now down to 16-bit depth. Again, this is the old CD standard. This only gives us 65,500 voltage levels, which is a 96 dB dynamic range. Totally fine for most applications with music. You won't really notice much of a qualitative difference, particularly with the recording of my voice, but it does make quite a difference for, say, scientific purposes when we really do need a very large dynamic range for whatever reason. Also, if you're mixing music, the quantization that you have, if you're doing the whole thing in 16-bit, the quantization noise does add up with each additional track you add. So even if the end result is at 16-bit, you want to be mixing at a higher bit depth than that to begin with. All right. Now we've reduced it down to an 8-bit level of quantization. This only gives us 256 voltage levels to choose from. And you should notice that the quantization noise is now increased quite dramatically. We've only got a dynamic range of 48 decibels between the louder sound we can encode and the noise floor. Okay, we're going to go crazy now. Let's drop the bit rate to 4 bits. This gives us 16 voltage levels, only a 24 dB dynamic range. I think you'll agree it sounds pretty awful. This is what a 2-bit recording sounds like. There's only 4 voltage levels. We have a 12 dB dynamic range, essentially. It's incredibly noisy. And this is a 1-bit recording, otherwise known as a bit stream. And you'll agree that it's virtually incomprehensible. It's certainly not pleasant to listen to. Okay, well, thank God that's over. So, yeah, I hope that was a good demonstration.